Neon, neon, neon. Ah, everybody loves neon, don't they? No, just me? Oh, okay. How's it going, Starseekers? My name's Got Cake, and welcome to Star or Shovelware. In this review, we're going to be taking a look at Breakpoint, an arcade scorechaser with a twin-stick control scheme, where instead of shooting, you utilise various melee weapons to defeat swarms of incoming neon enemies. Now, when the game first begins, we drop straight into the fray with no instructions on how to play. All we know is that enemies are spawning and we can swing our axe by hitting R or ZR to attack. After a couple of minutes playing, I'd lost all my lives and headed back to the main menu, where I found tips in the extras menu which teach you everything you need to know about the game's mechanics and its enemies. So there's only one game mode in Breakpoint, with our sole objective being to earn as many points as possible before losing all three of our lives. We always start with the axe as our weapon, and as soon as the game begins, enemies begin to spawn from the edges of the arena. Now, gameplay, if you hadn't guessed by the title, is mainly focused around the break mechanic. At the bottom of the screen, we see our axe begins with a level 1 charge, and our character is surrounded by a segmented ring. Light attacks performed with ZR consume one segment, whilst heavy attacks performed by hitting R consume two segments. And when all segments are consumed, our weapon will break, causing an explosion to destroy nearby enemies. You're also able to throw your weapon by hitting ZL, which will also cause it to break, providing it hits enough enemies. Now, each time enemies are defeated, they'll drop small charges, which we absorb by moving close to them, which builds up our charge meter. And we're unable to begin breaking our weapon without first having at least one charge level. So in order to build more charge and destroy more enemies, you need to move around the arena, dodging enemies until you build up a decent group of them. Then you can break your weapon to destroy a large number of them at once, and more powerful enemies will drop multipliers which provide more charge. You can gain up to 3 charge levels, and the higher your charge level, the more powerful your weapon becomes, increasing its damage and range. It also increases the number of attacks required to break the weapon, and doing this at higher charge levels causes a larger explosion, with a charge level 3 weapon destroying the majority of on-screen enemies. Following this explosion, your weapon's charge level is then reset, and there's a mad scramble to collect as many charges as possible before they disappear. Now, in addition to charges, enemies also have a chance of dropping a weapon, and the game contains 5 different weapons, each with their own attack patterns, damage, range and speed. Your playstyle will determine which weapon you prefer to use, and I favoured the hammer as it's the most powerful weapon in the game, and while its attack speed is pretty slow, its third charge level enables you to attack all enemies around you with a single swing. So gameplay follows a cycle of building up a group of enemies, then destroying them to gain more charge, and repeating the cycle as you try and stay alive and gain your third charge level as frequently as possible. While this can still be enjoyable, it does mean that the primary focus of the game ends up revolving around you dodging your way through enemies, rather than just wading into them swinging away with your weapon. Whilst you can still play the game in this way, it isn't very efficient and you'll soon find yourself overwhelmed as your small break explosions fail to destroy enough enemies. When it comes to the game's enemies, there's some decent variety here with 12 enemies in total, and each enemy is represented as a different neon coloured shape. The most basic of enemies are the green and red ones, which home in on your character attempting to collide with you. But other enemy types include light blue ones which try and shoot at you, red spiky enemies which explode after you destroy them, sending out bullets in 4 directions, and another light blue enemy which provides a shield to all its buddies in an area. Now, things start off relatively slow but quickly pick up the pace as more and more enemies spawn in around you. When you die in the game, either by colliding with an enemy or one of the projectiles, you explode, killing all on-screen enemies, but this also resets your charge level, and this can present an issue later in the game, as you often don't gain many charges after your death, and enemies can overwhelm you as soon as you respawn, quickly ending your run. So after you lose your last life and your run has ended, your score, number of kills and survival time is displayed, and you're placed on the global leaderboards. One thing that I thought was great about Breakpoint's leaderboards is that you can select another player's high score and watch a replay of their game. There are also some simple controls within these replays, allowing you to speed up and slow down the footage. I'd love to see more high score chaser games implementing a replay function into the leaderboards, as they allow you to learn how to play the game better by watching others. So I had quite a fun time playing Breakpoint. I like the creative spin the developers put on the classic twin stick arcade shooter formula, and while the game's graphics and audio were simple, I felt it complemented the simple gameplay mechanics and there wasn't any need to have anything more complex. So now we come to rating the game. Now I rate games between 1 and 5 stars, with a shovelware stamp of approval reserved for the worst games on the eShop. This is my own personal rating based on the quality and quantity of gameplay, and whether or not I feel a title offers value for money. For a rating, I'd give Breakpoint 2 out of 5 stars. Whilst I found the game enjoyable, and it's definitely one to pick up if you enjoy high score chasers and are looking for something different, I also felt that the weapon breaking mechanics forced you to adopt a specific gameplay style, and bar the variation in weapons, it didn't leave much room for different playstyles, which I think may potentially put some people off. You can get Breakpoint from the UK Switch eShop, where it's usually priced at £4.49, or from the US eShop for $4.99. Alternatively, the game's also available on Steam. And that's it for this review of Breakpoint. Hit that like button if it helped you out, and let me know your thoughts and opinions on the game in the comments section below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel to be notified of future Switch content and game reviews, and jump onto the Star Seekers Discord server to say hello. For now though, I just want to thank you all once again for watching, and until next time, game on.